Today I'm going to paint a tree in watercolour using just two colours. Firstly cadmium yellow and secondly Prussian blue. I find that using a yellow and blue will give me a far greater variety of greens than just using a green. I'm starting by using a fairly strong wash of cadmium yellow. The tree will basically have light from the right-hand side, so the left-hand side of the tree I'm painting in a slightly stronger colour, i.e. there's less water in the mix. I'm painting it on a not surface paper that's inclined at an angle of about 15 degrees so that the water and wash will work its way down the page. I'm not being too fussy about the shape, and the white places in the centre of it represent the light showing through the branches of the tree. I'm putting just a bare outline of a trunk and a few outline branches at the bottom of it. I continually paint and then overpaint the areas that I've already done to either strengthen by adding more pigment or by weakening by adding just water, which will be on the right hand side of the painting. Once I've created a basic outline using the cadmium yellow, I'm now going over it using Prussian blue. I'm not mixing the Prussian blue quite as strong as the cadmium yellow because it's a very powerful colour, and I'm not really trying to follow in too much detail the exact outline of the yellow, because I still want quite a bit of the yellow to remain on the paper on the right hand side, which is representing the side where the sun is. As I work my way down, I'm adding more and more pigment of the Prussian blue to give, or to try and give, a three-dimensional view of the tree. So just above the trunk on the left hand side will have the strongest amount of Prussian blue pigment. The wash is at various strengths. In some places it's very, very wet on the paper. In other places it's starting to go a little bit dry. And that can be an advantage because it will give different textures and different effects as the pigments either run wet in wet or don't mix so much in the areas where they're dry. The blue pigment runs down from the bottom of the tree into the trunk, and you'll see it actually mixing with the trunk, although I haven't actually put the brush in that area yet. You keep developing the strength as you go along. Sometimes you have to let the paper dry slightly before you'll get a strong effect. Once I've gone over it a few times, increasing the depth of the colour using the Prussian blue, I'll then go back again using the cadmium yellow. And you'll notice then that the painting of yellow on top of green will give a different colour to painting the blue on top of the yellow. So here we go now. I'm thickening the darker green areas at the bottom using the Prussian blue. The colour keeps running down to the bottom of the wash, and I'm moving it back up again to give the shadow effect that I want. Right, I'm now adding again that fairly strong mix of cadmium yellow over the top of the Prussian blue, and it's changing the colour. It's going into a different tone of green. But because it's quite a strong mix of yellow, it's not bleeding too much into the blue. If you make a very weak mix, which I'll do later on, it'll start drawing out the colour, and it's a difficult effect to control, but if it works, it can often give you quite a pleasant effect. And don't forget, as you put these colours in, they may look strong while you're painting, but when the paint dries, the colour will be almost half the depth of colour that you'll get when it's wet. Right, I'm adding more to that. I'm trying to pull out some of the paint to give an effect of branches, but really the paint is still too wet to have an effect, but it is marginally lightening it. And now it's dry, and you can see the final effect.